Wesley was born in Epworth, Lincolnshire, into the large family of Samuel and Susanna Wesley. Of about 19 children, 3 sons and 7 daughters survived. When John Wesley was 6, the rectory where the family lived was destroyed by fire. John was caught in the house, but was rescued from an upstairs window. This gave rise to a belief in his family that he had been spared for some special purpose. And later, John used to refer to himself as a brand plucked from the burning. This literal event was a powerful image of having been saved from the wrath to come. In May 1738, John and his brother Charles underwent a profound spiritual experience. John famously described this in his journal for 24th of May 1738.
In the evening, I went very unwillingly to a society in Aldersgate Street, where one was reading Luther's preface to the Epistle to the Romans. About a quarter before 9, while he was describing the change which God works in the heart through faith in Christ, I felt my heart strangely warmed. I felt I did trust in Christ, Christ alone for salvation.
Wesley preached the first of his open-air sermons in Bristol in 1739. Wesley was uneasy about preaching in the open air, but since many working-class people often felt excluded from the churches, field preaching became a key feature of the Methodist revival. Wesley went on to spend his life travelling the country, preaching to crowds on village greens, at pit heads, wherever he could find people to listen. During his lifetime, he travelled an estimated 250,000 miles and preached 40,000 times. John Wesley first came to New Mills in 1740, and his journal contains many references to his visits to the area. On Tuesday, April 7th, 1772, he writes,
"I went to New Mills. Notwithstanding all the rain, the house was well filled, for nothing can hinder this lively, earnest people."
Mr. Wesley evidently delighted to visit his people here, for at the age of 85, when all his bodily strength was failing, he left Macclesfield at 5 o'clock on Easter Monday morning, April 7th, 1788, and
"with a deal of difficulty got to New Mills, the road over the mountains being barely passable. But the earnestness of the congregation made amends for the difficulty of the journey. They were all athirst for God."
This was to be his final visit before his death in 1791. For the Wesleys, works, as well as faith, were essential to the whole of Christian living. And caring for the poor, for prisoners, for widows and orphans mattered a great deal. Methodists were not only interested in welfare, they were concerned to remedy social injustice. And John Wesley's last known letter urged the abolition of that execrable villainy, slavery.